Hello from the Bureau. Angus here to break down the major weather stories for the first half of this week. And for Eastern Australia, that's cold temperatures, frosty nights, but mostly sunny overhead conditions. For the West, though, it's yet another winter cold front approaching. Here's the overview of how the map looks as we move into the new week, with the major weather players being this red H, high pressure, which brings settled and sunny conditions, but in winter brings cold and frosty nights. There's also a low in the Tasman, which did impact the country over the weekend just gone, and will continue to do so with some dangerous coastal conditions. Then as we move into Wednesday, we shift our focus from the east to the west. This blue line with the triangles is a cold front approaching southern parts of Western Australia on Wednesday and arriving with a bit of a bang as well. But for the major population centres in the centre and east of the country, it's going to be those cold temperatures as you get out of bed and start your day, which is probably the main talking point weather-wise this week. This is frost for Tuesday morning, a very chilly night tonight, very icy and extensive as well. Tasmania up to Queensland, up to the Northern Territory, lots of places seeing a clear night, a calm night, and watching those temperatures just plummet overnight towards or below 0 degrees for many areas. In fact, some parts of the east will be as low as -4 degrees overnight tonight, including Canberra, which got to -5 degrees this morning, so potentially could even be a degree or so colder than that. A little bit more mild along the coastline from Adelaide through Melbourne, Hobart, Sydney and Brisbane, but single digits overnight tonight, no matter where you look. Rinse and repeat stuff for the following day. So Wednesday morning, another very frosty one, crunchy underfoot and taking a while for that frost to thaw out even after the sun gets up, because no surprise, those temperatures are low again, low single digits into the negatives for some areas. It's very chilly on Wednesday and still Thursday, Friday, more cold nights through the second half of the week. While we're on the East Coast, we do want to check out what's going on over the Tasman. This was the low here that did bring some snow through the course of the weekend. It's now over the ocean, but still seeing some strong southerly winds up the east coast, so a breezy day for people along the New South Wales coast today and again tomorrow. But perhaps more significantly than the breezy conditions, the giant waves which are being whipped up by the strong wind. 5 to 7 meter waves for the New South Wales coastal waters for Monday and into Tuesday morning. That will make things very hazardous for anyone trying to brave their boats over the next few days, and potentially some hazardous coastal conditions for people on the land. This is what we call a coastal hazards warning, and it's saying if you're at the beaches, if you're at the coastline along the New South Wales coast from Port Macquarie down past Wollongong down to the south coast, potentially some dangerous conditions, big waves into the shallows and maybe some water up and over low-lying coastal roads and properties. Now let's switch focus to the western side of the country, and we're going to look at what's happening on Wednesday. So not tomorrow, but the day after tomorrow, as a cold front approaches Perth. Not likely to arrive during the day, but once we get to the evening and into the night, that's when that cold front will arrive, and it's going to bring with it a bit of a bang as well. Rain with some pockets of heavy falls. Thunderstorms, including some severe thunderstorms, which could bring us damaging wind gusts, lightning, thunder and hail, all possible. We could well see some severe weather warnings get issued ahead of this event, so do keep your eyes out if you're in the southwest of the country. Compared to the front that went through over the weekend just a day or so ago, this one will likely be a bit stronger, a bit more wind, and bring a bit more rain with it as well, potentially more than 50 millimetres for parts of the southwest. Not seeing that much inland, but maybe a welcome 15 millimetres. That's all from me for today. Stay up to date through the Bureau website and app. Thanks for watching.